I'm Pastor Houston, and welcome to KidsTown Live. We've got a super exciting time planned for you today. We're going to be talking about God's game plan for our country. That's right, our entire country. God gives us a special promise in 2 Chronicles 7:14 that says He will heal our land and He will bless us. But it comes with some requirements from us. See, God's expecting us to do some things too. That's what we're going to talk about today in KidsTown Live. And I'm excited for you to learn the four things God wants from us. So let's get ready. On your feet, let's start off with some worship to our awesome God.
Oh, happy day, happy day. You wash my sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. I'll never be the same.
The greatest day in history. Death has beaten you, how rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Sorry, I was late. You ready to get into the day's training?
It's about time you showed up.
Hey, sorry. I said I was sorry. I was teaching a Yorkshire Terrier how to cook a grilled ham and cheese.
Well, sorry isn't good enough. You really expect me to believe that you were teaching a dog to cook grilled ham and cheese? How is a dog supposed to do that? They can't get cheese. A dog doesn't have any money.
Okay. Okay, shortstop, enough of all of that. It's time to get into today's training.
I don't think I need to learn from you. I've got skills.
Now listen, Todd, you're acting a little bit prideful, don't you think?
What do you mean?
Well, it sounds to me like there's not a lot of humility there. You think you're all that in a bag of chips. Let me ask you this. Did you think to pray to God before your tryouts the other day?
Well, no.
Well, it sounds to me like basketball skills are the things you need to learn today. You need to be learning the same lesson that the kids are learning.
What's that?
How to humble yourself and pray. I promise you, there's a lot you can learn if you just listen up.
Okay, I will. I promise.
Ah, that's what I'm talking about. Promise. It's all about a promise that God will keep as long as we humble ourselves and pray. And it's not just a promise for us, it's a promise for the whole country.
Wow.
That's right. If we want God's game plan for our country, we gotta humble ourselves, pray, and turn from our wicked ways. Now, in the meantime, let's work on some dribbling, okay? Now, the first thing you gotta do with dribbling is you gotta get a lot of spit going in your mouth.
You know I gotta tell you what you gotta know. Tell you what you gotta know. You know I gotta tell you what you gotta know. Tell you what you gotta know. Hey kids, it's me, Callie from the Valley, and I'm like here to tell you like what you gotta know. So every time today somebody asks you what you gotta know, you tell them. Gotta stay humble, got to pray, and God will heal our land today. Our land, or like our nation, like totally needs to be healed. It's like, whoa, you need Jesus, America. Like, he's the answer. But the Bible says we can't just like blame all the problems on others, you know? We have to like humble ourselves and pray for our nation. When we do that, God will do his part and heal our land. So every time today somebody asks you what you gotta know, you tell them. Gotta stay humble, got to pray, and God will heal our land today. And that is what you gotta know. I'm Callie from the Valley saying TTYL.
Is that really in the Bible? Thumbs up if you think so. Thumbs down if you think not. Moses' middle name was Brian. A man with a crazy name lived to be 969 years old. A man met up with a talking donkey. A prophet named Jedediah told Noah to build the ark. A guy ate a book. It tasted like honey, but it gave him a bellyache. Isaiah made soup with carrots and rocks. God gave a prophet a crazy bread recipe. David went to war with the Visigoths. Till next time, thanks for playing Is That Really in the Bible?
Hi, I'm Miss Becky. Are you ready for today's Bible story? Today's Bible story is found in the book of Luke, chapter 14. Jesus was invited to a banquet at the home of one of the Pharisees. This happened a lot during Jesus' lifetime. The Pharisees were the important religious leaders of the time. They were always inviting Jesus to their gatherings because they wanted to try to trap him into saying something wrong. While Jesus was at the banquet, he noticed many of the people were trying to sit as close as they could to the head of the table. They were doing this because those were the important seats. In those days, the closer you were sitting to the head of the table, the more important everyone knew you were. Jesus began to teach them something very important. He said, "Don't sit at the seat of honor. Instead, take the lowest seat." Jesus was encouraging everyone to sit at the lowest position and let others take the better seats. That totally went against the way everyone thought at that time. Jesus went on to say, "If you sit in the lowest seat, the host of the banquet may say to you, 'My friend, please come closer to me. We have a special spot of honor up here for you.' But if you sit in the place of honor, someone more important may come to the banquet and you'll have to get up and move so they can have your honored spot." Then Jesus said something huge. "For those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted." Jesus was saying that if you try to make yourself number one, you will probably embarrass yourself. Nobody should try to make themselves number one. Instead, we should put others first. If we do that, then God can place us in the place of honor that He desires for us. In your lesson today, you're going to learn the importance of being humble if we are going to see God's game plan come about in our nation. We must humble ourselves. The only way to do that is to follow the example that Jesus set for each of us. It's not always easy, but God will honor you if you choose to humble yourself.
Well, hello everyone! My name is Rachel Teese, but nobody goes by Rachel anymore, so you can just call me R. Teese. Now, I've just been working on my newest painting, but my hands are getting so tired, I need a break. So why don't you help me with today's power verse? See, the problem is I sleepwalk at night. And last night I was painting today's power verse and I started using pictures instead of words. So I need your help to help me figure out what it's supposed to say. Let's take a look at it. Then if my... what is that? Door. Door with a hole in it. Boys and girls, what could that word be? Oh, you know, maybe it's a peephole. Oh, people! People is the word! Great job, everyone. Who are telephone? No? Dialing a phone number. Oh, yes, that's it! Called by my name. Will, singing? What could that be? Oh yes, hum. Humble. Oh yes, humble. Themselves and hands. No, that can't be it. Ah yes, pray. And seek my smile. No, that can't be it. Happy. What could that be? Ah yes, face, and turn from there. Purple angry man. No, that's not it. Ah, wicked. ways. I will ear. No, sound. Boys and girls, what could that word be? Oh, yes, hear from heaven and will, for present gift. Oh, yes, that is it. Forgive their sins and restore their land. 2 Chronicles 7:14. That's it! Great job, boys and girls. Now, let's make sure that we don't forget it. So everyone stand up and say it with me on the count of three. 1, 2, 3! Then if my people, who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and restore their land. 2 Chronicles 7:14. Great job, everyone. You can all have a seat. Now, would you like to see what I've been painting today? It's absolutely marvelous. It's a unicorn riding a bicycle in the sky. You know, I had a dream about this once and I've wanted to paint it ever since. I think I'm going to hang it in my bathroom. Well, thank you so much again for all of your help today. I'll see you later, boys and girls. Bye-bye.
Hi, boys and girls. I'm Pastor Houston, and let's talk about today's Bible story. You know what? I love my country. Do you love your country? Isn't it wonderful to live in a country where we're allowed to come to church and to learn about God? I mean, there are quite a few countries in this world where believing in Jesus is illegal. People aren't even allowed to gather in churches to learn about Jesus. Well, we are blessed to live in this country. But there are definitely some things that we need to change in our country. Sin is everywhere. We need God to heal our nation. We want God's game plan to come about, don't you? Well, today we're going to be learning several things that we need to do in order to bring about God's game plan for our nation. But before we get into that, I have to tell you something. Check this out. Look at this. I got this week. You know why I got this? Because I placed first place in being the best person ever. I went and bought this first place trophy right here because I know I'm the best. I got good grades in school, I'm serving God, I saved up lots of money, and I'm just an all around awesome person. I mean, look at all this awesome stuff I do. I mean, who wouldn't want to be my friend? In fact, everyone wants to be my friend. And you know what? That's how awesome I am. I've done all kinds of awesome things for other people and for church, and I can guarantee that God is proud of all that I've done. Number one. Okay, wow. Yeah, I know some of you were probably wondering what I was talking about and how I was talking that way. Well, you ever know someone who was so full of pride like that? I'm sure you have. Hopefully you are not that someone who talks or behaves like that. If so, let me remind you about what today's power verse says, that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and restore their lands. You see, this promise of God is for our country, but it's really giving us some very important instructions. It tells us the first thing that we need to do to see God's game plan unfold for our nation. So what does humble mean? Well, according to dictionary.com, humble means to lower in condition, importance, or dignity. So, how do we do that? When you humble yourself, that means you are making yourself lower by elevating God. And you see, by you doing that, it makes God more important than us. God has to be number one, not you. So how do we do that? You admit that you don't have all of the answers. See, God knows so much more than we will ever know because He's God. And you don't have to have all the answers because God does. He's the only one who knows everything. Now, the next thing that must happen in order for God's game plan to work in our nation is... how many of you have a daily time of prayer set aside for God? Do you do it at the same time every day? Well, if not, it's time to start. But the real important question is, why do we pray? Well, let me help you understand. I'm gonna bring in my friend. This is Zach.
Hey, boys and girls.
Zach is our youth intern here at Northgate. And I've just decided Zach's gonna be my bestest friend ever. But I'm never gonna talk to Zach. In fact, I'm not gonna spend any time with Zach at all. But I'm just gonna say he's my best friend ever. Well, do you think it's gonna work? Do you think we'll become best friends? I mean, if I don't ever talk to Zach, and if we don't ever do anything together, then how are we ever gonna get to know each other? That's what I'm talking about. Thank you, Zach. You see, the same principle applies to our relationship with God. How will you ever get to know Him and talk to Him if you don't ever spend time with Him? Well, you won't. Make spending time with God a priority in your life every single day. Now, next, we have to realize that... what do you do when you want to know how to do something at school? Well, you ask your teacher. And what do you do if you want to become a better baseball player? Well, you talk to your baseball coach. And what if you get a brand new amazing Lego set? Like this one. And you want it to look exactly like it does on the box. Do you just start randomly putting pieces together, hoping it works out right? No, you check out the instruction manual. That's right. This is all the things that you need to know to put that together. Well, I tell you what, in life, you will face lots of situations that you won't know how to handle. But you serve a God with all the answers. And guess what He's given us? That's right, He's given us a Bible. It's a guidebook for living. And when you don't have all the answers to the problems in life, seek after God. Read the Bible for guidance and pray. And listen to what He has to tell you and what He wants you to do. The last thing that you need to realize, if you want God's game plan to come about for our nation, sin has corrupted our world, but it doesn't have to corrupt you. Don't fall into the trap of sin. Remember what the Bible said the price of sin is? Death. Instead, let's do what Amos 5:14 says. Do what is good and run from evil so that you may live. If we want to see God and hear from heaven and have Him restore our land, then we must obey these four things. Humble yourself, pray, seek God's face, and turn from sin. Then we will see God's game plan come about in our nation. Our Heavenly Father, we thank You for our lesson today. We thank You for the country that You've given us, that we live in one nation under God. And Lord, we want our country to be better, and we want You to heal this land. We want You to help us as we fight the battle of sin. So Lord, help us humble ourselves. Help us pray. Help us seek Your face, Lord, and help us turn from the sin that we have in our lives. And we thank You ahead of time for all of this. In Your Son's name we pray. Amen.
shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable.
Come on.
Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable.
Okay, like, what you gotta know?
Oh, look at that! Hey, boys and girls, guess what time it is? It's time for Brain Drain, and I am James Brady, and I'm here to give you your lesson on what we've learned today. So let's start. Here we go. Question number one. What you gotta know today? Well, what do you have to know today? I will be humble. Pride is bad. Or gotta stay humble, gotta pray, and God will heal our land today. That sounds like a song. And the answer is, gotta stay humble, got to pray, and God will heal our land today. I think I should have been a singer instead of a football player. Here we go. Question number two. Where was Jesus in our Bible story? Was he at school? At a banquet? Or at the temple? Which one? Where was he when our Bible story started? He was at the banquet. Great job. Question number three. Soccer. Where were all the guests doing, or what were all the guests doing that Jesus had to correct? They were doing something they shouldn't have been doing. What did Jesus have to correct? Were they trying to sit in the seat of honor? Were they going to eat before they pray? Or were they going to feed the dogs? Which answer is correct? Do you remember? Well, the answer is they were all trying to sit in the seat of honor. Only the honorable one can sit there, not everybody. So number four. Jesus told everyone to always sit in the blank seat. What seat did Jesus tell everybody they should sit in? The best seat, the biggest seat, or the lowest seat? Which one was it? Well, the correct answer is the lowest seat. You should always sit in the lowest seat. Question five, we're halfway there. Does Jesus want us to be full of pride? That seems like an easy one. Should we be full of pride? Yes or no? And the answer is no. We should not be full of pride. Question number six. According to our lesson today, I must blank myself. I must humble myself. I must love myself. Or I must know myself. Which one is it? I must humble myself. Yes. According to our lesson today, I must blank. I must sing. I must dance, or I must pray. Which one, according to our lesson today, we should do? Well, the answer is I must pray. All right, great job, eight. We're almost there. According to our lesson today, I must blank God's face. I must seek his face, I must find God's face, or I must ignore God's face. Well, the answer is, let me hear you. It is seek. I must seek God's face. Number nine, according to our lesson today, I must run from storms, I must run from sin, or I must run from sharks. And the answer is, I must run from sin. That is right. And our final question is, where was our power verse found today? Was it 2 Chronicles 7:14, Hebrews 10:23, or Luke 15? Try to trick you. And the answer is 2 Chronicles 7:14. Great job. Kick the score. Goal! We will see you boys and girls next week. All right, boys and girls, we are at the end of KidsTown Live this week. Thank you for being with us. And remember, God has a plan for our nation. All we have to do is humble ourselves, pray to him, and he will heal our nation. Isn't that awesome? So let us pray right now. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you. We love you. We're grateful. We're thankful for being in this country. I know times are tough right now, so we just pray that we humble ourselves and that we trust you in all things. We love you, Lord. We pray these things in your Son's name. Amen. So remember to rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks for all things, for this is God's purpose for you in Christ Jesus. We'll see you next week.